Harper Audio presents King of the Bench, Kicking and Screaming by Steve Moore, performed by Maxwell Glick. Prologue. My name is Steve, and I am a bench warmer. In case you don't already know, I love sports. I'm not a hotshot athlete or anything. Not even close. So I only get into games when the score is about 100-0. And I'm fine with that, because I love the other stuff that goes on around the games almost as much as playing. Like when I stick my face in the pocket of a spanking new baseball glove and take a big whiff of the fresh leather smell. Or when I put on a football uniform and I look like a gnarly Roman gladiator with a huge chip on his shoulder. Or when I ride a bus to an away game and pull off all kinds of shenanigans with my friends. Unless we're sitting in the front seats right next to the coach. So I love sports, but I don't love every sport. Here are a few examples of sports that don't exactly fry my burger. Bullfighting, skydiving, synchronized swimming. I can hold my breath for only 10 seconds. But there is one sport that I really dislike, and it's probably the most popular sport in the entire world. In this book, I'm going to spill my guts about how I blabbed my opinion about that sport and practically ruined a close friendship. And about my embarrassing bodily affliction. And about a kid from Brazil with superhuman athletic skills. And I'm not even exaggerating. Right about now, you're probably curious.
So, Steve, what is the most popular sport in...
Stop! Sorry, I can't reveal any details right now because, big drooly duh, it's pretty much a rule when writing a book that you don't just blurt out the juicy plot stuff in the first few pages. So I'll tell you more when the time is right, or I get in the mood, whichever comes first. All you need to know for now is that even though I'm a bench warmer, I do have some skills. For example, I have excellent hand-eye coordination. That's a huge advantage when I dive to catch a baseball inches above the ground, or when I dribble a basketball, or when someone in a museum shouts, "Think fast!" and I have to catch a priceless Egyptian vase. So I'm not a total drooling dweeb, okay? And when it comes to sitting on the bench, I'm probably better at it than anyone else my age in the entire city. Maybe the entire world. End of the pine or middle of the pine, doesn't matter. I pretty much rule the bench. No brag, it's just a fact. I'm king of the bench. Chapter 1. Okay, I'm in the mood now. I was going to keep you waiting until the suspense built to the point where you couldn't stand it a minute longer, but I'll spill my guts right now. I don't like soccer. There, I said it. Ace bench warmer Steve Moore dislikes the most popular sport in the world. Maybe even the entire universe. Quick time out about why I don't like soccer. There are several good reasons, okay? It's not like I'm just cranky. First of all, unlike the game of basketball, there's not much scoring in soccer. A final score of 2-0 is pretty much a blowout. Scoring is so infrequent that if you look away for even half a second to squash a mosquito that's sucking blood out of your arm, you might miss seeing the only goal of the game. And soccer players run up and down the field with very few breaks. There are no timeouts unless you keel over from a broken leg or some other ailment. And when there's a foul, the ref holds up goofy yellow or red cards. Why not just signal with your hands like in basketball or football? But the main reason I don't like the game of soccer is that my body has lousy foot-eye coordination. I call it foot-eye dweebitis. It's an embarrassing affliction, worse than when you get lice in your hair and then everyone at school finds out about it. I already told you that I have excellent hand-eye coordination, but if my feet are asked to do anything more than walk, run, or jump, that's when foot-eye dweebitis rears its ugly head. And in soccer, the feet do most of the work. So someone with foot-eye problems either won't make the team, or if they do, they'll be sitting on the pine. I'm pretty sure that foot-eye dweebitis is due to faulty internal communication wiring. I tell my leg to kick the ball, and all it hears is, lick the wall? Leaving us both confused. So soccer doesn't exactly fry my burger, but I made a big mistake by saying so. Out loud, right in front of a best friend, who happens to love the game of soccer more than any sport in the entire universe. Chapter 2. It happened at the sports stadium that sits right smack in the middle of my neighborhood. My best friends and I practically live at Goodfellow Stadium because we all pretty much love everything about sports. Joey is quick as a flea, and he's psychic. I knew you were going to say that! Carlos, well, he's a grouch. That's him growling.
Grr.
And Becky, she's got nature's near-perfect smile. The stadium is really ancient. Archaeologists estimate that it dates back all the way to the early 1980s. Old people get all emotional and weepy-eyed whenever they walk through the gates because Goodfellow Stadium has hosted a bunch of memorable moments, whatever that means. The stadium has a rickety domed roof that slides open and closed, so it can host any kind of sport in any conditions, except maybe a Category 5 hurricane or a direct hit from an asteroid. On this particular day, my friends and I got into Goodfellow Stadium for free, as usual, by helping the concessions workers unload boxes from delivery trucks. As a bonus, they always give us a treat of our choice. Joey selected a churro because his tiny revved-up central nervous system demands a constant supply of sugar. Carlos grabbed a family-sized bag of roasted peanuts. He sucks the salt off and then chews up and swallows the peanuts, shell and all. Becky and I chose the same treat, an Eskimo pie. It's vanilla ice cream covered in chocolate. In case you don't already know, it's pretty much nature's near-perfect food. Not a commercial endorsement. We were at the stadium to watch our hometown professional soccer team, the Goodfellow Wise Guys, play an exhibition match against FC Barcelona, a hotshot soccer team from Spain. Our team was getting slaughtered by the Spanish team. 1-0. I wasn't thrilled about watching a soccer match. My friends practically had to drag me to the stadium. But Joey, Carlos, and Becky are soccer fanatics. Becky was especially excited. She knew all about the FC Barcelona team. She even knew the first and last names and personal backgrounds of every one of their hotshot players. We were sitting way up in the very top bleachers, right under where the lice-infested pigeons roost. Our good friend, billionaire Bill, was walking around the upper decks of Goodfellow Stadium, blasting an air horn to scare the pigeons out of the rafters so that spectators wouldn't need umbrellas to protect their heads, if you know what I mean.
Where's the restroom? You're perched over it!
Bill is the stadium's official pigeon control officer. He calls himself a bleacher bum because Bill actually lives in a cramped apartment beneath the bleachers for free, in return for his important pigeon duties. Bill once was a very successful and respected rocket scientist. Or a star player in the NBA. Maybe an umbrella salesman. I forget. Anyway, his previous life apparently got way too comfortable, so he decided to shake things up and get out of what he calls his comfort zone. Next to my mom and dad, Billionaire Bill is my favorite adult role model in the entire world. Bill took a break from blasting the air horn at the pigeons and sat down with us. He usually offers all kinds of wisdom that anyone would be foolish to ignore. But this time, Bill looked down on the soccer field and said something that I didn't exactly agree with. Soccer is a magic game. There was less than a minute left in the match between the wise guys and the hotshot Spanish guys, and a grand total of one goal had been scored. What's magic about that? To me, it was boring to watch, so I expressed my honest opinion about the most popular game in the entire universe. I hate soccer. I didn't say it very loud or anything. It was more like a mumble. But I immediately regretted saying it, especially because I used the H word. The power structure, Mom and Dad, practically made me poke my finger with a needle inside.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.